Dearly beloved, I welcome you to the Old Central Church at the Jacob Henry Mansion Estate to celebrate this joyous occasion today. We are here to bear witness to the coming together of Nicole and Matthew on their wedding day. Today is a celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people who are in it together for the rest of their lives. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Nicole and Matthew, by coming here today, you have now taken the initial step in what will be a wonderful and lasting life together. Marriage is the promise of hope between two people who love each other sincerely, who honor each other as individuals, and who wish to unite their lives and share their future together. A marital commitment includes a willingness to be open and vulnerable and having the courage to take risks. Your commitment today is to accept the challenges of establishing and nurturing the intimacy of your partnership. Marriage is going to expand you as individuals, define you as a couple, and deepen your love for one another. With this wedding, you'll be brought together as one, yet you are still two separate individuals with unique ideas, talents, and ways of being. Respect and value those differences, and your marriage will flourish. For a marriage to be successful, you must be loyal to the other, stand firm in your defense of each other, and be supportive of one another's life goals and dreams. A good marriage is one that fosters respect and a willingness to compromise with each other. In addition, you will need strength, courage, patience, and a really good sense of humor. These are the foundation blocks of marriage. Well, Nicole and Matthew, you are finally here. It's your wedding day. It's been a long and winding road, but you've decided to finally commit to each other and have chosen your person for this journey ahead of you. You have created this comfortable and passionate relationship where you've grown together and taken the time to get to know each other. It's hard not to see how you've affected and transformed one another into the people you are today. From spending a lot of time with each other's families and building on your initial friendship, you have made your relationship stronger than ever and celebrated the little victories. By taking the time to mature together, your relationship has flourished and taken you each farther than you ever thought possible. Nicole and Matthew, you have used each other to build a strong, supportive relationship that continues to supplement and balance your own lives as well as your life together. Your support for each other has allowed you to bring each of your own interests into the relationship without sacrificing your own individual spirits. I challenge you to continue to raise each other up, to keep each other calm and comforted, and to work towards your goals together. It won't always be easy, but as long as you have each other to lean on, I'm sure you'll be able to continue on this magnificent journey ahead of you. I offer you one final piece of advice. Continue to keep your relationship relaxed and your communication open. Remember to be humble. Always come back to each other. Of course, there will be some great days and not so great days. But as long as you take care of each other, your relationship will continue to evolve as you build your lives together. If it is your intention to share with each other all the joys and sorrows that the years will bring, join hands and commit to each other with these promises. Nicole, please repeat after me. From this day forward, I choose you, Matthew.
I choose you, Matthew.
To be my husband.
To live together.
And stand by you always.
To work side by side.
And to encourage you. In everything you do. I will be there to listen to you. To laugh with you. And to hold you. I will be your friend. Your partner.
And will love you.
All of my heart forever. Matthew, please repeat after me. From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I choose you, Nicole.
I choose you, Nicole.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To live together.
To live together.
And stand by you always.
And stand by you always.
To work side by side.
To work side by side.
And to encourage you.
And to encourage you.
In everything you do.
In everything you do.
I will be there to listen to you.
I will be there to listen to you.
To laugh with you.
To laugh with you.
And to hold you.
And to hold you.
I will be your friend.
I will be your friend.
Your partner.
Your partner.
And will love you.
And will love you.
With all of my heart forever.
With all of my heart forever.
Who has the ring? May these rings symbolize the promises you have made today, your dedication and unity to one another, and give you the strength to honor your commitments to each other. May they remind you that marriage is not a destination, but a journey, with no beginning and no end, just a moment-to-moment opportunity to love and be loved to the best of your ability. Matthew, please place the ring on Nicole's finger. Nicole, please place the ring on Matthew's finger. Nicole and Matthew, I leave you with one final blessing. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you have learned much from one another. You have said a few words that have taken you across a threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. May your hands be forever clasped in friendship, and your hearts join forever in love. Your lives are very special. God has blessed you in many countless ways. God has brought you two together forever. May his blessings rest upon you and fill all of your coming days with love and adventures. Nicole and Matthew, please turn around and face your now combined family and friends. It is my pleasure to present for the first time anywhere, Mr. and Mrs. Matthew and Nicole Lane. You may now kiss the bride. Nicole and Matthew would like me to thank you all for coming to their wedding, and they will meet you next door in the reception. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you.
A lot of sleepovers. Honestly, she would sleep over at my place, or I would sleep at her place probably at least once a week for, I don't even know what period of time that was, but it was probably a couple of years worth. So. Yes, she's left over at my house every night after, pretty much after Bible study too, or once a week at least. And we did a lot of late nights watching movies or Sex in the City. It was our thing, even though I wasn't really into it, I loved hanging out with Nicole, so. Okay, let's just, she was more. Okay, anyways, but Matt, you were just one lucky guy, because Nicole, honestly, I don't know if I've ever said this to you, but you are seriously one of the nicest people I've ever met. I didn't think I was gonna start tearing up, but she's one of the nicest people. She always puts others first. She always wants other people to be happy before herself. Honestly, I don't know, I'm sure you guys all know this, Nicole just really cares about other people. And she'll always be there for you. No matter what you need, she would drop everything and come if you needed her. And she's always up for everything. Like, no matter if you wanted to stay in and watch movies or if you wanted to go out dancing on a whim at 10 p.m., she would be like, let's go, let's do it, whatever you want to do. And I just love that about her because I feel like that's me too, and I always wanted somebody like that that would be just able to kind of do whatever on a whim. So I love that about you, Nicole. So I just wanted to thank you for being just honestly one of the least, like honestly, she's never judged me for any of my craziness. just being one of the people that's most accepting, always there for me, and yeah, just a really fun friend. You'll support me no matter what. And I honestly, I don't know if I ever said these things, but I really mean that, so. You know, so I got married here 10 years ago at Jacob Henry Mansion, same place, and you know, I decided that I have a couple words of advice. So, the biggest things, so 10 years ago, my husband and I, having been married 10 years, it feels like so much less. But honestly, the biggest thing is just communication and just loving each other no matter what. Like honestly, putting each other before, you know, anybody else, loving each other no matter what little thing comes along. You know, you're gonna have hard times. So, I'm honored to be a part of this wedding. Honestly, I was taken aback that you asked me to be your matron of honor. I feel so honored. And I love you so much. And I pray for you guys, I'm so happy for your family too. So, and I pray for you guys for continued joy, fun adventures, and growing love. And Romans 12:10 says, be devoted to one another in love, honor one another above yourselves. And I just pray that for you guys, that you would honor each other above yourselves, that you would always be there for each other. So, it may be cheesy, but it's true. Join me in toasting to love, laughter, and happily ever after. So, thanks, guys.
Next, we'd like to pass the microphone to our best man. That's John this evening. And John has a few words to say to the bride, to the groom.
I couldn't be happier to be here today to see you guys start your next chapter here. You make a fantastic couple. You've got a happy, smart son. You've got a brand new apartment and many other things to look forward to over the next several years, many years, your lifetimes. I wish you a lifetime of happiness. Cheers.
Okay, bridegroom, you want to say anything to your guests? Otherwise, we'll start eating.
I'm not much for public speaking, but this is a pretty small room anyway. I just want to say for us both, we're so, so grateful for every one of you that came. For you to be in this room, you must be very important to us, because we were right on the end of our useless. No offense to anyone who's not here. We hope that you have a great time tonight. It's going to be a pretty short night as far as weddings go, but we're very, very happy to share this day with you, and we love you all.
So I'll keep it nice and sweet and short. So we love you all very much. You're very important to us to be here today, as Nikki said. Apparently Nate wants to say something. We'll go ahead and let them sit there. Yeah, just enjoy yourselves, have a good time. Again, thank you for coming. I know it's probably a good distance for a lot of you, so we appreciate you taking time out of your schedules, especially during times like this with COVID and everything. Risking your health literally to be here with us means a lot to us, so thank you again.
Join our new little couple on the dance floor, because that's what friends are for.
And I never thought I'd be this way.
Tonight, and so we'll continue the slow songs for a little bit.